certainly can't go back to an economy based on inflated profits and maxed out credit cards, the cycles of speculative boom and painful busts, a system that put the interests of the short term ahead of the needs of long term. That led us into this mess. We need to move forward with the policies that are leading us. What we can't afford right now is to go back to the same ideas that created this mess in the first place. We can go back to the days when promising industries got set up overseas. And that's why I think it's so important that we not take this country backward, that we don't go back to the broken system we had before. We've got stacking the deck against ordinary Americans. To me, that's not an option, not after everything we've been through. We can't go back to the same policies that got us into this mess. We can't afford to go back to that brand of you're on your own economics, not after the American people have worked so hard to come back from this crisis. In other words, the wealthiest few Americans will go back to the income tax rates they were paying under Bill Clinton. We've come too far and sacrificed too much to go back to an era of top-down, on-your-own economics. And under the Affordable Care Act, if you want to change jobs, go back to school, or chase that new idea, you can do it without worrying about going broke if you get sick. The issues we're grappling with go back decades, even centuries. Today I'm announcing new steps we are taking to do exactly that, to give people across America who have lost their jobs the chance to go back to school today to get retrained for the jobs and industries of tomorrow. The idea
is believe that rather than go back to the pursuit of short-term profits and a bubble and bust economy that led us to this point, we could build an economy based on sound ideas, solid investments, hard work, in order to secure a long-term prosperity.
If you go back 50 years in this country, the amount that's been spent in energy R&D is dwarfed by healthcare, NASA, other places. I think
the best thing about being president, by the way, is having a home office. Because that means that, that means that I get home for dinner. And even if I have to go back to work. And that makes all the difference in the world. So.
And the hope is that you go back to your home states, to your communities, and you encourage your family, friends, constituents to find ways to continue to serve.
And all right, I think we're ready to go back to the audience.
And, this is an example of where folks say, well, you know, should the Obama administration be taken on too much? The fact of the matter is that if we don't pass financial regulatory reform, then banks are going to go back to the same things that they were doing before.
And so I'm going to have to close up my business and I'm going to have to go back to doing something where I can get health insurance. I mean, those stories, everybody knows them.
And going to the hospital, they're supposed to fix you. Suddenly you have to go back 3 weeks later.
When do you go back to school?
I'm going to hold it.
I go back to school September 3rd.
September, bubbles and busts. It was an economy in which recklessness and not responsibility was rewarded. We can't go back to that kind of economy. If we want a country that succeeds in the 21st century, then we have to lay a new foundation for lasting prosperity. And health insurance reform is one of the key pillars of this new foundation. It was an economy that rewarded recklessness over responsibility. So we can't go back to that.
That's why we need Ben Bernanke to continue the work he's doing. And that's why I've said that we cannot go back to an economy based on over-leveraged banks, inflated profits, and maxed out credit cards.
I want everybody here to hear my words. We will not go back to the days of reckless behavior and unchecked excess that was at the heart of this crisis, where too many were motivated only by the appetite for quick kills and bloated bonuses. You've already seen and lived the consequences of what happens when there's too little accountability on Wall Street and too little protection for Main Street. And I will not allow this country to go back there. It is on backlogs that go back years. Now, as I said, I know since a lot of these problems have been going on since Katrina happened, people understandably feel impatient.